Mr.JayJay here, and today we're going to be playing some more Madden 21 Face of the Franchise. You already know how we be. Right, continue. I didn't realize that I had loaded up, honestly.
Spin the block around just like the hands on the clock. Come like a bat of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like a finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best.
Hey, how do you think I press X, man? To like start this, man.
My chance to start a regular season game arrived unexpectedly in the middle of week 7. Our starter was injured, and I was the next man up.
All right, Jay here. You're taking over for the start of this week. You know, it's gonna channel a lot of my nerves, energy into dominating from the moment the ball is first snap, coach. These guys, man, they should have just had them talk, man. It's not that hard, man. I know I'm gonna get someone who's saying, oh, they can't do that because they got a narration. There's a way that you could format your storytelling to where they can actually talk and you can get the, whatchamacallit, the narration. Because if it's just about the narration, then you can have the narration all the way through, giving a basic rundown of what would be there. Los Angeles Chargers. I think they're the LA Chargers, right? Or I think so. I'm honestly not sure, man. I tell you what, though, bro. I was just thinking about like how like I had accidentally caught some of the dudes shooting up before the game. Like, tell me why people are actually using juicing up and using steroids and stuff. I'm like, for what reason? Like, I mean, we don't need like we didn't need that. Like, you know, like because it was my senior year of high school. I was like, bro, we literally don't need that, bro. We're a solid team, and we honestly could have made it to the playoffs easy. But like, it's just like too many selfish decisions kind of messed everything up. You know what I mean?
Tonight we close out week 7 with a good Monday night matchup.
And it's like, bro, they're like, so like, it was right before one of our home games, and so I just happened to be walking in the back, because like we had put our stuff up and all that, because like we're in like these locker rooms for like the home game or whatever, but like they're not like our actual locker rooms, so it's just like a random locker room that's used for that. So it's pretty much our locker room, but like it wasn't necessarily like our stuff.
Reaches the 27. Allen, a big play there on the first play of the game. 46 yards. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. The numbers on the ground for Montgomery in last week's affair. And he is in. Touchdown.
There you go. Just like that. Yeah, and so like pretty much where we were. Alright, so I know y'all know those like little portable things. Like, you know, like So, you know, like, let's say you're in, like, middle school or high school or something. Then you got those small little, buildings. I can't think of what they're called. There's, like, these small little buildings that are usually right outside, those schools just for, like, extra space. And some teachers and stuff, they use them for, like, extra, classrooms and stuff like that. Well, so that's pretty much what we were using. The only difference was it was, kind of, like, too connected. And, like, there were just lockers in there. And so, we were in, like, the coaches usually be in, by, like, the front, of them. So it's, like, they had those, they're, like, kind of, like, in, like, the first one. And so, like, that's usually where, like, the offensive players be. It's usually where, like, the O-line is and the D-line. Those are what you're usually going to see there. And, like, pretty much your, like, third string and people who don't play. Like, those are the ones you're going to see there. Then, like, you got, like, your actual stars and stuff, as well as, like, me and, like, a lot of the special teams people and, like, that second one. And, like, when I say stars, I just mean, like, starters. And so, like, yeah, so, like, yeah, it was two linebackers who were, like, literally, like, the two starting linebackers were over here, like, shooting up with steroids. I'm like, bro, what the fuck? Like, because, like, I mean, obviously, I didn't say anything. But, you know, they had, like, the stereotypical brown sack. And they had, like, one of those, like, yellow thing. Like, I mean, well, like, the liquid was yellow. But, like, it was, like, I would have to show y'all when, like, I play, like, Blitz the Lead or something. Because, like, the thing is, like, it was literally that color. Crap, man. Falling over here, falling off the bed. But, like, it was literally, like, that color that you could tell that it was that. You know what I mean? Like, there is, like, no doubt in my mind that that's what that was. Holding. Thank you. Like, there is, like, absolutely no doubt.
The tally there, minus 8 yards, leads to fourth down as well. Throwing on third. That's complete to his tight end.
And so, yeah, so, like, there was, like, this extra wall that was right there, and they kind of, like, was shooting up behind the wall. I was like, damn, bro, that's wild. And, like, what I came to find out was, at the end of the, like, it was after the end of the school year, because, I was at my, one friend's party where they were going off to the military. And then so there was, like, me and, like, several other people who were, like, on the football team that were there. And, like, one of them was, like, my friend. You know, he actually came to the stream. He was Ryan. But I guess there's two of them that did come to my stream. But the thing about it is, like, touchdown. Yeah, but, like, so I'd have to point out which one it was. But, like, he even told me that, because, like, one of the other dudes on our football team was over here talking about, one of the guys, and then my friend, Ryan was like, oh, yeah. No, like, yeah, you know they used to take steroids? I'm like, yeah, I think I saw him shooting up one time, and he was telling me they were shooting up with someone else. I'm just like, damn, bro. Like, someone else that I didn't even know, but, like, it was, he saw a completely different time than me. So he was just telling me about the other time he saw, while I was telling him about the time I saw. So, like, it was freaking crazy that they've done that like multiple times, and then like they even had like some of the like one of the younger guys doing that, you know, it's pretty crazy. Man.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way, just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
I also think throwing away, like when you're about to get sacked, should be like you're down where you're throwing. Because the thing is, like, don't get me wrong, if you just see no one opening, you throw it out, okay, fine. But if it's like, there's a dude in the backfield who's literally about to sack you, and then you quickly throw it out, nah, you need to be down.
Now Goff on first down. Now get this one to Kopp, complete. Goff, a gain of 6 there on first. Burke working with a 2nd and 4.
Pick up the 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
Goff throwing again. And they work the receiver. It's Robert Woods. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 38-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
At the 38-yard line.
On first down. Goff. That's incomplete.
There you go.
He doesn't drop many like that one. 2nd down.
Woods. Incomplete.
They work again from the 38 on 2nd and 10.
Fuller.
Again, Goff gets it off to Freeman. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. They face a 3rd and 4.
Yeah, but like,
after that last completion, gets them 6. This pass,
like, the thing is, like, honestly, and this is just the way I am, like, if we were, like a team that was winning a lot, and then I found that out, I honestly probably, like, I wouldn't have, like, snitched, like, told them who was, but I would say, like, hey, I think, more of a, like, I would straight up either tell the, head coach, or, like, no, the Chargers are San Diego. Yeah, so they're the San Diego Chargers, not the LA Chargers. What the fluff was I talking about before? There we go. Yeah, I'm sorry. But, like, I definitely would have, like, said something, not necessarily in his name, but I would have been like, yeah, we need to probably do more drug testing because there's guys in our team that are using drugs. Well, like, are using, like, performance enhancement drugs. Dang. Just challenges it.
And for a Rams touchdown, Josh Reynolds, his 4th touchdown.
The only reason I want to challenge it is because there's nothing to challenge.
And the Rams are able to get back within a touchdown. On for the extra point, Giorgio Tuvecchio.
Yeah, so, yeah, but yeah, I would have definitely said that, but that's just because of the way I am, because, like, I feel like, I wouldn't have said it, like, in a way where it's more like, I'm not just saying that because I would want to snitch, just to snitch, but I will say that because that'd be, like, cheating, you know what I mean? It's like, wow, we're only winning because, like, we're cheating, you know what I mean? And, like, I wouldn't really like that, you know? And also, because then it would beg the question, who else was doing it, you know what I mean? So it's like, let me find out that all the starters are just shooting up, you know what I mean? And plus, you already know, like, there's a bunch of people on drugs, like I said before. You're getting, like, high and stuff before the game, so it's like, oof, first down.
Get a knock that off somehow, chip away at that time, and change things up a little bit, and make them go to other things.
So, like, the thing is, it's pretty much, like, because, like, the thing is, like, at the end of the day, it's one of those things where it's, like,
a lot of people call this offense one-dimensional. I think you did. Well, it was you. I'll be honest. I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that
catch the ball.
Like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right because we did have
it's like one of those things where it's like, even though, like, it may seem like for a selfish reason, me feeling like I'm cheating, like, it's not just straight up selfishness. Because you also gotta remember, these are still like, these are like people who just barely turned 18 like a year ago and stuff like that. Like some of them are, but like the younger guy that he was getting into like the shooting up stuff, he was only like 15, 16, you know what I mean? It's like, bro, these are freaking, like, they're like bad influence on like the younger guys, you know what I mean, that are gonna be going in there. So it's like, that's one of those things where it's like, so that's like one of those things where it's like, I'm only trying, like, I'm looking out, you know? Oh, snap. Like, one of those things where I'm really am looking out for the team, though. I gotta get 17 the ball because he was celebrating with me.
Well, we saw so much of this last year at the college level, but there you go, his first rushing touchdown as an NFL quarterback.
And with the speed he has, we certainly know it won't be his last because that's something that
that was a late hit.
At the college level, it's something he's going to carry
clipping
over, and they'll make it a big part of their offense.
Oh, man. Can't do that. Oh, roughing the kicker, PAT is good. Oh yeah, I hate how like they added on to the kickoff.
Because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Yeah, but like, that's like one of those things. Like, you can't really be doing that. But it was funny, but the other guy who was like, on, like the one who was saying that, that's who was trying to tell me and Ryan that they were using steroids. He was like, bro, you could even just tell. Like, if you ever seen his PB, I'm like, bro, y'all be wilding, man. Y'all be freaking wilding, man. I'll tell you what. There would never be like, the people like they were in my, like, on my football team, bro. They were over here wild and time out, over here looking at each other's penises and stuff. Like, bro, what the fuck is it? Like, oh, and that's not even like, oh, that even reminds me more funny stuff. And I'm glad that I said that because now it reminded me of more stuff. Like, there would be people on the football team that would just go and just start humping each other for like, because they thought it was funny. You know what I mean? And it's just like, why? Wait, why? Oh, you're here just like, warm on, just humping them. And it's just like, bro, come on, man. For no reason. And then they would get aggressive. And it's like, the dude obviously doesn't want that to be happening with them. And then sometimes they'd be doing that stuff while they're in their freaking underwear and stuff like that. Sometimes they do it on the naked. And just be like, bro, what the fuck is wrong with y'all?
A nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense.
Like, 39 just slipped on the ground, I felt, for no reason.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit.
And that's Murphy's Law. If it can go wrong, it will go wrong. But yeah, man, nah, but like, I mean, every time they try and do that on me, bro, I'd be quick to throw hands. Oh, I like how it says end racism on their helmet. I didn't notice that before. Did it always say that, or actually, I had just been patched into the game and I didn't know that. Because it even says it on theirs. So maybe I didn't know that, man. I could have been saying that this whole time, but I didn't. I'm just now noticing that. But yeah, bro. But like, I mean, I'd be quick to like start throwing like punches. There was like one time they tried to get me, and like we had this huge TV inside the locker room. Like think of one of those like really fat TVs. And it's on like one of those like stands, but like it's like a big TV. Like I don't know, like not like a flat screen, but like just like fat, like one of those fat fatter TVs, but like one that could still be like held up against the wall. You know what I mean? Like, so like think of a box TV, but like it's like able to be like put like on a wall. And so like that's pretty much what it was. But well, I guess it wasn't really put on the wall, but like more toward the ceiling. But either way, it was connected. And then, like, I freaking grabbed that and was freaking threatening to freaking pull it down, pretty much. Because, like, they were trying to grab me. I'm, like, grabbing this. It's like, bro, you try and bring me to the ground. Think you're going to do that to me? Nah, man. And see, man, Mr. JJ, he will always been a savage, man. Mr. JJ always been a savage. Savage. Classy, bougie, ratchet. Y'all know y'all like that.
The inside linebacker Danny Trevathan gets the sack.
And like I'm even fine with that, like that right there, where it's like, oh, you're about to get tackled, but you're having a teammate at least over there, and then you're throwing it to him. You know what I mean?
On is the punter Hecker as he gets this one away. And this one hits at the three and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for the
yeah, but
drive.
I tell you what, the people on my football team would be freaking wild with that. Just being overall like freaking nasty.
You don't have to be a genius to watch this game and figure out they've had plenty of success moving the football here in the first half. We've seen exhibits A, B, C.
Dude, 68, you're going to have to block somebody now.
We just saw exhibit Z right there. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. This is caught. And he doesn't quite make it. Taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. So we reach halftime with a visiting
Fluff, I did not pay attention to the clock. Oh my goodness, I did not pay attention to the clock. Because, like, we could have cushioned, like, straight up. Like, it would have been, like, 35 now.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
Webster, and I ain't talking about the dictionary.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams start a half, other teams just go.
And just like that, the whole pacing change of the game.
They had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return, he has a dangerous Cordero Patterson.
Dang. Got his lights. what's it called? I don't even know.
Now Allen Robinson and company gearing up to go again on offense.
Texas. Texas. Over 200 yards. I don't think we saw it as that good. And I think what really makes it square. I meant to say 17. Because that's his number.
It's continuing to adjust throughout the game because you know the defense is kicking coverages towards him, trying their best to slow him down, and he keeps getting the better.
Yeah, whatever they've done, it hasn't worked. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
That's a 32 yard.
They're going to hurry back to the line.
Nah, but like, honestly, though, I would definitely see a lot of the people on the football team. I mean, I don't know why. Well, like, they weren't gay, but like, they would definitely do a lot of these things. And like, the thing is, like, the issue isn't really what they're doing. It's like why they're doing it. Like, they're pretty much just doing it for no reason. While also doing it because they think it's funny to do it to someone who's not really like. Like, granted, that was almost a pick. Like, you know, it's like kind of like they're not really like consenting to it. It's just like. Oh, get him. And I just start tackling him. I started doing that. Do him, you know what I mean? It'd be so funny. Like, I mean, granted, no one takes it personally, which is good, you know what I mean? But at the same time, it's like, bro, y'all shouldn't really be doing that. And I'm not trying to sit there and be like, saying that to, my boy. And I'm not just saying that to pretty much be like one of those people that are like. Oh, catch the ball. If you would have caught that, man.
Jalen Ramsey right there in coverage to knock it away. Line of scrimmage, again, the 4 yard line. Second and goal. Again, this is Montgomery. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown.
Yeah, but like the thing is like, it's like one of those things that's just like wild, you know what I mean? And like, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people really wouldn't see an issue until like, bro, this dude went through like five dudes to freaking score. That's insane, man. But like, it's one of those things that I feel like you gotta definitely see, you know, before. Before you can really like talk about it, you know what I mean? Because like a lot of it, like they really haven't like, cause like I think like me saying it doesn't really talk like really 100% tell you like what is going on, but. Like, it's not really like that good, you know what I mean? But you know what would be wild though? It's like, even though when I was like younger, because like I've been talking about my senior year, even when I was like freshman or sophomore, junior, like even the older guys would straight up do that a lot to the young guys too. So it's like, it's not like, oh, it was just a younger or the older thing. It's just one of those things that like everyone tries to do, you know what I mean? But like, I like, there's stories of like one dude over here putting his finger in a dude's butt, like people smacking their peepees against each other and like messing around like that, and it's like, bro, what the fuck? You know what I mean?
6 yards was it's the like, pickup on the last completion.
Like, I mean, again, like, it's fine if, like, okay, both of y'all want to do it, and y'all do it, you know what I mean? But then it's another thing if, like, one person don't want to do that, and then another person just, like, pretty much forcing themselves on that, you know what I mean?
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. to bring him down. They tried to run it to the short side.
And like, I think that's what room to work with. Yeah, it seems like I think that's a better way of putting it. It's pretty much like the sideline, and he kept looking for a spot to dive up into the gap. There just wasn't one, so that turned into nowhere to run. Not all sides are pretty much the consenters, and that's pretty much what I'm trying to say. It's like pretty much someone is essentially putting more of their they're pretty much dominating it, you know what I mean? And it's like, whether you like this or not, this is what's happening. So yeah, but like, I mean, like, if I think of more stuff, man. And that's, I guess that's kind of the reason why I hate the phrase locker room talk. Because like, with locker room talk, a lot of females really think that when they're not around, guys just go and be saying like all this stuff around them, about them, and like all that, like, which I mean, yeah, maybe for about a minute, but and it's not even gonna be really that in detail, you know what I mean? Like, no guy is gonna sit there and just talk like 30 minutes to an hour about like some freaking chick, bro. No, like, they don't, like, or even longer, they don't care, bro. Minute max about a female. Minute max. With the only exceptions being a chick that they like. And then that would probably be no more than 5 minutes. Like a chick they like or a chick they're trying to get with. Then that may be no more than 5 minutes. But like, my thing is like, the way they try and portray locker room talk is like, oh, it's just this constant thing, and I'm just really, really, really negative. Which honestly, a lot of the times, it's not that negative either. But my point in saying all this stuff is like, really, when chicks aren't around, guys are usually just messing with each other. That's the point I'm trying to get. Is like, my right eye is bright. That's pretty much what where I'm trying to get at. Like, yeah, like, guys typically only talk and mess with people that they're around, you know what I mean? So if they're not, like, around any females, or they didn't just have an interaction with a female, they're not going to talk about a female. Crap. Hold on. I gotta put some eye drops in my eye. Because my eye is like burning bad. Especially on that play. There you go. Hold on. Yeah, but like, that's like my thing. It's like, if a guy. So like, it pretty much like this. Like, a guy really won't sit there. And dang, bro. It seemed to get worse when I put the eye drop in there. So yeah, a guy won't really be too interested in like talking really about the female because they're too busy living in the moment. And that's one of those things that why I sit here and say like, you can't really just hear the locker room talk and what it's about. And then act like, oh, you know what guys are doing behind closed doors and stuff like that. And one thing I can say, now, this is just me being, since I'm a guy, obviously I've been around guys since I don't even know freaking how long, like my whole life, you know what I mean? So I'm going to sit here and tell you, like, if I'm being straight up right now, I'm going to sit here and tell you that guys really don't be talking like that. Like, how, like, the media portrays them and how they portray locker room talk, that's not how guys are. Not turn it over. Keep And that's why if you see guys are so quick to denounce locker room talk, because no female really has like sit there and experience that, you know what I mean? Because it's like, who are you, what kind of guys have you been around that have been over here locker room talking like that? You know what I mean? Because like, guys don't do that. Guys really don't do that. Like, guys really do not be doing that crap. So, like, and one thing I would say is, like, even when they do talk about females, it's not really like, oh yeah, oh my bad, I'm not meaning to do that. Oh yeah, I wanna go and chick, or like something like that. Or, oh yeah, that chick's so busted, she's so ugly, she's so this and that. Like, guys don't be saying that. Like, I mean, some a good chick might say like, ah, nah, she too fat for me, or ah, nah, she too ugly for me. But like, that's it. Like, in response to someone asking, oh, do you like this chick? Or, hey, you should get with this girl. You know, it's not any more than that. You know, and like, I feel like a lot of women, especially those who don't know the situation, try and make this sound way worse than what it really is. You know what I mean? And so like, that's why I don't like the locker room talking.
Why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Everyone be quick to talk about men, but you know, you don't see people talking about the locker room talk for women. And women, they would freaking eviscerate anyone who's not around. Like, oh, that's my bestie? Bro, they were going to eviscerate their bestie. Oh, that's my boyfriend? They're going to eviscerate their boyfriend. Oh, that's my best friend? That's my guy I got in the friend zone? They're going to eviscerate him, you know what I mean? Like, I honestly, now that I think about it, I think men stuff that they do. Because... And like, and I'm only gonna say this because I've kind of experienced it, not necessarily because, oh, I'm being the women's locker room or anything like that, not because that, but like, girls straight up would just talk about whoever they want. They would straight up gossip and do all that stuff, you know what I mean? And like, that's just stuff that they do, whereas guys mainly talk about like sports and cars and like maybe like politics and stuff. Women typically talk about like each other and like other people and stuff like that, and aside from like maybe like TV shows like and stuff like that, they're really just talking about people. And so like, when so like, the thing is like, pretty much what I'm saying is like, guys don't really be talking about like people like that, but women do. I think women starting to think that men just do what they do, but to like a worse degree, because I think that nowadays it's popular that women are men are supposed to be bad. Dang, you know what I mean? Because like, you either make fun of the men, you know, because, you know, men ain't nothing these days. No, I'm just kidding.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9.
Bro, I fluff 54 bad, man. I'm sorry, Floyd.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 14 yards gets into Chicago, first down. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second.
Yeah, but, yeah, that's one thing that I'm starting to, to see now. Because, like, because I'm telling you, man, and, like, if you're a female and you're watching myself, guys don't really say, like, talk like that. No, and I really want y'all to know that. If it's not addressed, guys won't say jack to you. Like, if it wasn't addressed previously, guys won't say jack about you. They won't even mention you in a conversation.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up. And Miller will pull this one in. He's got it for the Bears touchdown.
That's what I'm talking about. Bro, that dude about as skinny as me. Well, like, muscular is me, is what I meant.
Touchdown passes, that's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
The kick is good.
And he'll bang that one through. So that drives 7 plays in length. And the end result is a Bears touchdown.
Eddie Pinheiro to kick off for Chicago.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. On the return comes Webster.
Yeah, but yeah, so that's pretty much, so like addressing locker room talk, that's pretty much how it is, man. And like I said, man, you can't sit here and argue with like over 20 years experience around guys with like female hearsay, you know what I mean?
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. The first down screen pass, good for 5. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Goff on first down.
Oh, catch it, man. Hey, 91 should have been more aware, man.
Intended for Devontae.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again is Goff. Open man is Higby, the tight end. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. They get 6. That'll leave him with 3rd and 4.
Third and 4.
To the air again. Goff.
User.
It's up by Kyle Ford. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. So the Bears with a football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
He's taken down at the 33-yard line. A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And at the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Back to throw now on first down. This is where the fourth quarter.
Ooh, good job. 17, my boy. I like him.
Kind of sucks the will out of them, doesn't it? Because they don't want to tackle him right now this late in the game.
Well, you say that with accusatory tones. But you're exactly right. I know it's not something we actually want to talk about. But as a defender, 4 quarters worth of trying to bring people down, 4 quarters worth of pounding.
And I didn't mean to do that, honestly.
Here comes that big guy coming at you. And a lot of guys are wondering where they want to come up and make that tackle at this stage of the game.
That was and looks like he'll throw here. Being chased out left. This is caught. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Brandon, remind me again. This is a rookie quarterback we're seeing?
A rookie indeed.
I mean, because my eyes are telling me something, I'm having trouble believing. Five touchdown passes. He's thrown five in this game. Are you kidding me?
Extra point right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead.
Eddie Pinheiro to kick off for Chicago.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
I like how they changed the Washington's thing, because they're no longer the Redskins.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
But it was funny. I wasn't,
another incomplete pass there. What do you take from this game
offensively? Well, you know it's tough to really analyze.
I didn't, like, because, like, the thing is, like, I don't really have anything to say after the whole locker room talk thing. But I think it's really opened my eyes. Just me talking it out, like, really opened my eyes to it, you know what I mean?
Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack.
Because, like, I'm telling you, man, like, I've heard some stuff, man.
So Goff, he'll try to refocus after the sack. The Rams,
and honestly,
set up with a tough one, a third and long.
Fun fact, I've actually heard. Oh, that was like a good lurk, I mean. I actually heard more, like, sexual, encounters with females rather than being around guys. Which is weird, because, like I said before, I've been around them longer. And, like, I mean, even if you want to, like, argue, like I said, dude, get out the way! Like I said, like, if you want to, like, if you want to argue something, one thing I would sit here and say is, like, even when the guy would say something like that, it wasn't, like, anything too long, you know what I mean? Like, either. Like, it was, like, probably, like, maybe, like, again, like, a minute, like, no longer than 5 minutes about this.
Second and six. Flush to his right. And he's got it.
Dang, didn't get in. I was trying to get a 6 touchdown. Bro, in only 2 games, I'm already at like 900 yards.
What were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Chicago, that's now 5 wins on the campaign as they get the job done here. And they'll return home next week to take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Rams, they fall a game under the 500.
Like, I feel bad for them. It's like they lost, but it's like they couldn't control the fact that they lost, man.
They head down to Miami to take on the Dolphins. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank
Wait, we're the same number. So I don't know when he was in or where I was in. Oof. Yeah, but, like, bro, but, like, honestly, like, what I could say, though, is, like, the females, like, a lot of them be going into, like, deep, like, details and stuff like that. Like, just, like, unnecessary details. Like, really trying to paint the picture for you is, like, what I mean. You know what I mean? It's like, that's pretty much what it is. But, like, guys, they don't really paint the picture. They just tell you what they did. And then that's it.
The hugs, handshakes, and most of all, the words of encouragement from my mentor.
You are on fire out there. Keep doing that and you'll be our starter before you know it. Oh, that's our boy. Number 12's our boy. So then what was number 17 celebrating with us in the celebration?
My teammates recognized my performance out on the field, and I was ready to show them that things were going to get even better.
I wish there was, like, extra training you can do for your character. Or, like, extra practice or something like that.
It was a tough break for the injured guy, but this was huge for me. The press wanted a quote, which is how things happened like they did.
Who do you want to model your career? Lamar Jackson? Yeah, probably Lamar Jackson. Yeah, but like I was saying, like the females, bro, they were going in like such detail. Guys, they just tell you what they did. Yeah, I fluffed her. I blew her back out or something like that. It ain't gonna be, yeah, me and Joe. We hold on.
I like trade deadline. Use Allen Robinson or Khalil Mack. Ooh, we gotta go with our boy. I'm sorry, man, but we gotta fight for our boy. And plus, I feel like if we would have sent the other dude, our boy would have been mad at us. Yeah, but like, bro, like, with the girls, they would be telling you the time of day and everything. Like, usually, like, with a guy, another guy would have to ask them, like, a guy isn't just going to go straight into detail. You know what I mean? Someone would have to bring that detail out to them. Females just be like, just telling all the business. Bro, I'm catching up to them on the leaderboard, though. Like, 1,000 or 276 yards. And, like, 2 games. Like, that's freaking crazy. I want to see how many games they had. Dang, I don't know how to see how many games they had. Wait, did that say, oh, week 7? What the fluff? That's crazy. But yeah, that's gonna do it for this gameplay. Please comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't already. Please share with your friends, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.